Hey everyone, and welcome to Cooking Companion TV. I'm Jenna Edwards, and this is a recipe demo of lime coconut fish with sesame greens, adapted from a recipe I have from the Viking Cooking School. So give this video a thumbs up if you like it. We start with a can of unsweetened coconut milk, unshaken, so the cream separates from the thin milk. So we can scoop out 2 tablespoons of the cream to set aside for later. Then pour the rest of the can into a pan with 2 cups of a rich chicken or vegetable broth over medium-high heat. Add 1 large smashed or torn clove of garlic, 2 tablespoons of lime juice, 2 green onions coarsely chopped, 2 kaffir lime leaves or 2 3-inch long pieces of lime zest, and a 1-inch piece of galangal or ginger root thinly sliced. If you have to peel your ginger, it's easiest to use a spoon to scrape off the skin. And add 1/4 teaspoon of crushed red pepper flakes. You can add 1 tablespoon of fish sauce now or stir it in later when you're tasting for your preferred flavor. Bring it to a boil and then reduce the heat and let it simmer for 10 minutes. Remove from the heat and cover the pan, letting it steep for about 20 minutes. Now we work on the greens. Slice a medium shallot and finely grate 1 tablespoon of fresh ginger. Heat 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil over high heat and add the shallots and ginger, sauteing for only 30 seconds or so. High heat is deceptive because that really means just above the medium heat indicator on your stovetop. High heat is reserved for stir frying and boiling water. This is slightly too hot, which is why I have a splatter screen. The oil is popping all over the place. We obviously don't want to burn anything. We're just trying to brown the shallots. Then add in 1/2 cup of thinly sliced shiitake mushrooms. If you've washed them off, either give them time to thoroughly dry or squeeze the water out of them before adding to the hot pan. The water will make the oil pop out more voraciously. Mushroom flavor develops more fully when you let them brown. So once I add them to the pan, I'll let them sit there for a couple of minutes while I prep my cleaned bok choy. Same thing as with the mushrooms. Make sure there's no water still hanging around on your greens. You can cut your greens however you like. I'm doing long, thin slices of bok choy and a bag of frozen spinach. I like to think about how I want the vegetable to behave with my fork or on a spoon or whatever in the entire dish. I want to be able to pull out the little pieces of greens and mushrooms along with little pieces of fish for a perfect biteful. However you decide, add your greens to the pan after just a couple of minutes of browning the mushrooms. I won't stir it up yet because I'm still letting the mushrooms brown, and that can usually take 5 to 8 minutes total. And the heat from all of this is steaming the greens. By now it's probably been close to 20 minutes, so I'll strain my broth and I'll squeeze out any remaining flavor I can from the aromatics. If you like al dente vegetables, you are done cooking the greens. I don't, so I'm stirring to keep it going. At this point, taste the broth. If you didn't add the fish sauce earlier, do that now too, or add more if you want. I really like tart broths with all the earthiness going on in the rest of the dish, so I added more lime juice. And I decided that I'm done with my greens now. So I drizzle on 1 teaspoon of toasted sesame oil, give it a good stir, and transfer the greens to a serving bowl and keep them warm. And finally, let's do the fish. I'm using sea bass, and the original recipe calls for black cod, which is a buttery sablefish. We first season the fish with salt and pepper, and a sprinkle of cumin and coriander. Pan searing fish is a new process for me, so I'm glad you get to see the process. Again, I think the pan is too hot because you'll see how the oil pops again and my fish sticks, which is not supposed to do. So I heat 2 tablespoons of peanut oil because it can handle higher heat, and place the fish skin side down. If the heat is right, the oil crisps the skin and creates a barrier, releasing the skin from the pan once it's cooked. If I were on my gas stove, the heat indicator ranges from 1 to 6. So medium high heat is about at 4. And I would heat my pan just a tick under the 4 so my oil is hot but not angry. The skin should release in a couple of minutes, which does not happen here. I have to fight to flip the fish. And then we cook on the other side of the fish for another couple of minutes. This is a thick slice, so I use a thermometer to determine doneness. It should reach an internal temperature of 140 degrees Fahrenheit to be fully cooked. Once you sear the fish on both sides, you can roast the fish in the oven for a few minutes at 450 degrees Fahrenheit to reach doneness. I decided to leave them in the pan for a few more minutes just to fully cook because I was annoyed that I had to use the oven. But the meat starts to separate when it's done, and that's a visual cue. And now we plate, which is the best part about this dish. Ladle in the broth, then pile the greens and mushrooms in the middle, placing the fish skin side up. That's how you present fish. And you dollop on the coconut cream we reserved at the very beginning. You will have broth left over, and I highly recommend it. Recommend saving it for a shrimp curry or even a winter squash soup or curry. I'm not sure it freezes well, so I'd be ready to use it up within 2 to 3 days. That is it for this beautiful presentation of lime coconut fish with sesame greens. The recipe is below or at cookingcompaniontv.com/limecoconutfish. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it and subscribe to this channel for more demos just like this. I'm Jenna Edwards, and thanks for watching.